fancy it's time. Edward, Ruby. Ready, Edward? Very well, Ruby. Right, Edward.
What have you done, girl?
Miss Radson, just switch.
No, it's all right, Rose. Is it properly down this time, Daisy?
Yes, Mr. Radson.
Oh, Ruby, what were you thinking of? If anybody had seen that, they would have thought we were just a nest of spies.
Sorry, Mrs. Bridges, it came off in me.
No, never mind, my girl, never mind. There's no harm done.
Well, stop that noise now and go and see about the tea.
Yes, Mrs. Bridges.
Oh, that girl. We ought to send her to fight for the Kaiser. The war would soon be over then.
I'm glad we used this green stuff. We won't be able to see a thing through it.
Possibly we'll need to put drawing pins in at the side. No inadvertent chinks. That is to be the motto in this household.
Yes, Mr.
Hudson, you don't seriously think that the Zeppelins are going to get as far as London, do you?
Well, if they do, I'm going to climb up the string and stick a hatpin in them. And if the Kaiser comes over, I'll stick a hatpin in him, too.
Quite right, Mrs. Bridges. Though, strictly speaking, I don't believe the Zeppelins have got strings attached. Rose, Edward, Daisy, we will now go and draw the curtains upstairs. Come on, look sharp now.
Georgina didn't come in to tea.
No. Billy Linton's on leave. She's gone to a Tay dance-aunt with him.
I suppose that extraordinary form of entertainment will become more popular than ever now. With all the street lamps turned out, people will want to get home early.
I doubt if Georgina will.
Mm.
Yes, Hudson.
If we might draw the curtains, madam.
Rather early, isn't
it? I thought we'd better make sure that the blackout is in order, sir, since I understand that the street lamps are not going to be lit tonight.
I see.
Very well, Hudson.
I trust we're not offending against the Defence of the Realm Act.
I will send Edward outside, sir, to make sure that there are no chinks.
Oh, there's another one done. I do hate sewing curtains. I must try and get hold of some more black material for the spare room curtains.
Spare room? You're expecting visitors?
Not really. Prudence wants to hold her committee meeting here tomorrow.
Committee?
Her Belgian refugee committee.
Now, Hazel, you're... Do you know, I passed two smartly dressed women in Whitehall yesterday. One said to the other, "Have you got your Belgian refugees yet?" As if it was a new fashion in house furnishing.
But if they have nowhere to go, Richard...
Hazel, no more committees. You've taken on too much already.
Oh, I haven't really. Anyway, I prefer to be kept busy.
I know.
Do you suppose James was at Mons?
Yes, it does seem likely.
I wish he could write more often.
Oh, I expect we shall hear before long.
Things are bad, aren't they?
Quite serious. If the Belgians give up Antwerp without a fight, the Germans will drive straight through to the coast.
That would mean a German invasion?
Well, it will certainly bring the possibility a great deal closer. If only I could take some active part in it all.
You have a voice in Parliament.
Oh, yes, to criticise Asquith for his conduct of the war. Which is necessary, I suppose, but which hardly seems patriotic. Or even particularly effective. Anyway, don't let Prudence talk you into anything.
I won't.
But they were sweeping snow out of the carriages in Edinburgh, Mr. Hudson.
I dare say they were, Edward. But it was not snow off the boots of Russian soldiers.
But I was talking to this friend of mine in the Crown and Anchor.
Was he there himself?
Well, no, but he was talking to a friend who knew one of the porters.
I dare say.
And there was that ruble they found in the pen in the slot machine near Durham.
Ruby? Have you been gossiping with that butcher's boy again? Now go and fetch the old plates. Come along, everybody. We've got a nice bit of haddock for our high tea today. Don't let it spoil. Edward, put that paper away.
But Mr. Hudson, how comes this then? If it isn't true, how does it get put about? I mean, it's in the paper, clear as daylight. 90,000 Russian soldiers passing through England on their way to France. 90,000?
I mentioned the matter to the master, and he said it was 90,000 eggs.
Eggs?
A cable was sent which read, 90,000 dispatched from Archangel. But it was not soldiers, it was eggs.
Oh, oh yeah, well, they might say that.
Oh, no bacon, Mrs. Bridges.
The mistress says we've all got to economise.
Yeah, that's all very well, but our keep is part of our wages.
Edward, if the greatest sacrifice we have to make is to eat haddock without the customary roll of bacon, we will not have much to complain about.
Well, the war will be over by Christmas anyway.
I wouldn't be too sure of that, Daisy.
How are things on the war front, Mr. Hudson?
Rather grave, Mrs. Bridges, I'm afraid. The German attack has been halted in the River Marne, but Paris is still threatened. And there was a wee hint in the Times today that the Belgians might not be able to hold Antwerp.
Oh.
And it would appear that the Russian army suffered a severe defeat several weeks ago.
I don't know why we're fighting on the same side as them Russians anyway. Nasty lot of anarchists.
The anarchists, Mrs. Bridges, are exiles who, in my opinion, should all be clapped into prison immediately. But it's only natural that we should be allies of the Russians, the Tsar being a cousin of our king.
So is the German Kaiser, isn't he, Mr. Hudson?
There are misalliances, Edward, in every great family.
Well, I don't care what happens as long as Eddie don't get mixed up in it.
He may have to, Daisy.
Yeah, like your kitchener said, his country needs him.
Hold your tongue, Ruby. If this year prescription comes in, that'll be quite time enough for Edward to go.
I trust that should the need arise, every true Briton will enlist without the need of a conscription, Mrs. Bridges. But in my opinion, that time has not yet come.
I hope it never will.
We shall see, Daisy. For the moment, Edward's duty lies here. Ruby, pepper, please.
Well, I said to Connie Harcourt, I cannot understand these people. I mean, naturally, one keeps one's butler and chauffeur. And for the sake of the horses, one cannot part with one's grooms. Now, I thought we should have sent our under gamekeepers, but Henry said the poachers would become so tiresome.
Well, your husband is a justice of the peace, isn't he? Perhaps he could sentence the poachers to enlist immediately.
And it's no laughing matter, Prudence. We have sent 7 servants from our town house alone. And yet here are all these people with their houses full of able-bodied men and refusing to part with them. How old do you suppose the butler is here?
Hudson? Oh, he must be at
least... I shall have a word, Mrs. Bellamy. She comes from Wimbledon, I believe. Oh, this war is going to be a boon to the middle classes. What with the committees and sewing parties, and nobody being too particular, they are going to get in everywhere. Where is Mrs. Bellamy?
Well, Hudson said she'd gone shopping.
I'm sorry.
Here's Sylvia. My dear, I don't think you've met Lady Berkhamsted.
How do you do? I would have been here sooner, but on my way back, there was a woman sitting on the doorstep.
What, of this house?
A drunk, I suppose.
No. She was a charwoman.
A charwoman? Well, surely you could have left it to the servants to
She got a telegram before she left home this morning, saying that her husband had been killed in France. Well, she came to Eaton Square as usual, but on the way home, it came to her. She got as far as here, and then... like suddenly being drowned in grief. I touched her. I spoke to her and she didn't hear me. I've never seen anyone crying quite so dreadfully.
It's very distressing.
Well, I couldn't just leave her. Mrs. Bridges is giving her some tea in the kitchen.
Well, I think you were quite right to get her off the street. No, really, these people have absolutely no self-control. Personally, I agree with Mrs. Edward Littleton. Mourning should not be allowed. People should be proud to feel that they have given their nearest and dearest in their country's cause.
Well, perhaps she'll feel that later. Naturally, at first, she's... well, shall we set to work for our gallant Belgian refugees? Lady Hardcastle was so sorry she couldn't be here. She has her own committee meeting this morning.
Connie would have a committee of her own.
Would you care for coffee to be served, madam?
Yes, please, Edward.
How old are you?
Me? I'm 25, madam. I'm a lady.
And you are not married?
No, my lady.
Mrs. Bellamy, you really will have to think of sending him to a list. We all have to make sacrifices, you know. And it is up to people like us to set an example to the others.
Yes. Thank you, Edward.
Mrs. Arthur Harrower is willing to serve on the committee.
Oh, not Mrs. Harrower. A more tiresome, encroaching woman I have yet to meet.
Yes, but she has that large house, and she's willing to take two Belgian families.
Oh, well, certainly. I have no objection to her doing that.
Oh, well, you've taken long enough.
What?
Do they want coffee?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Oh, come on. The poor creatures are coming over in fishing boats, dredgers, even colliers, anything to get away. Most of them have left all their possessions behind and have only what they stand up in. It's too tragic. Mm.
Dreadful.
How many are there?
Well, they say 5,000 at least. And if the German advance continues, we can expect twice that number.
Oh, good heavens, where are we going to put them all?
Well, there are reception centres, of course. Mm. There's a large one at Wandsworth, but they can't stay there. More are arriving all the time. Oh, thank you, Edward. Of course, many of them are just simple peasants. And the best thing would be to send them straight out into the country onto farms or big estates where they can work on the land.
Well, Henry has some cottages at Breckley. I dare say he could put them in there, temporarily, of course.
Oh, that would be excellent. And then we must draw up a list of friends who are ready to take in the better-class Belgian into their home.
Well, I should have thought the better-class Belgian would have relatives in England with whom they could stay.
Oh, my dear Violet, not all of them. Angela Carstairs was telling me the most tragic tale yesterday of a Comte and Comtesse who fled from their chateau with all their children, arrived at the reception centre absolutely penniless. She'd even left her jewels behind. Well, I mean, we must do something for people like that. Now, Hazel, dear, how many can you take?
I would like to do what I can, but I shan't have much time to look after them, and I don't want it all to fall on the servants.
Mrs. Bellamy, we can hardly sit on committees like these, asking other people to help the war effort, unless we are prepared to do something ourselves.
Yes, of course. I expect we can take one family. I wonder what they'll be like.
I read a book once, one of Miss Lizzie's. It was called The Scarlet Pimpernel, and it was all about this gallant Englishman what saved the aristos.
Harry what?
Aristos. That's French for lords and ladies.
Oh. Here, ours are Belgian aristos, aren't they?
That's right. Yes, this one I do. It's got Lady Marjorie's monogram on it.
Oh, look. Where? Oh.
Yes. I think I'll give them my stuffed hair.
Do we know how many to expect, madam?
Well, Lady Prudence said she'd try not to make it more than three. That might be a mother and father and one child, or a mother and two children.
I've ordered the spare room to be got ready, madam, and Rose is putting a cot and a small bed into the nursery.
Oh, that's splendid. Good morning. Did you enjoy yourself last night?
Oh, yes. Billy said it was the last opulent evening before going off to the dreadful rigours of camp in Darkest Kent. I thought I'd go and stay with the Fox Breedens for a few days and then I could see him.
In camp?
He says he can come over for dinner when he's tucked the men up in bed.
I see.
Uncle Richard says we're going to have some Belgian refugees. What fun.
Yes. Oh, Hudson, I wondered if there were any toys in the house.
Oh, yes, madam, there are some in the nursery cupboard, which belong to Miss Elizabeth and Captain James.
Good. I'll go through them.
I'll do it if you like, Hazel.
Oh, would you? Thank you, Georgina.
Shall I do it now?
Is that all right, Hudson?
Certainly, madam. I will send Daisy up to help you, Miss Georgina.
Thank you, Hudson.
Will there be anything further, madam?
Yes. Hudson, do you happen to know if Edward is thinking of enlisting?
Edward? Oh, certainly not, madam. I have explained to Edward that the time may come when it would be right for him to enlist, but that for the moment his duty lies here, especially this night.
Yes. That's what I thought.
Is that the purse, Edward?
Yes, sir.
It gets later every day. Now, Hudson, I'll be lunching out, but dining at home.
Very good, sir. Edward.
Mr. Hudson?
What were you thinking of putting the letters into the master's hand instead of presenting them on a salver?
But I was going to put them on a salver, Mr. Hudson, but I didn't have time.
We are not going to get slapdash in our ways just because there's a war on.
Nothing from James, I'm afraid. If there had been bad news, we should have heard.
Yes.
Well, you're getting your Belgium refugees after all.
Why, I'm sorry, Richard.
My dear, you did what you thought was right. If you hadn't, it wouldn't have been you.
I'm afraid it isn't quite as simple as that. Oh, I do feel sorry for them. But I think perhaps it was much more wanting to show that we were as patriotic as Lady Berkhamsted.
Anyway, you made the right decision. These people are our allies. They've suffered terribly. The least we can do is take them into our house and do what we can for them.
Miss Lizzie never was much of a one for dolls, so someone might as well get the use of her.
If it's a little boy, he can play with this.
Yeah.
Here, Eddie. Look, haven't they come up lovely?
All this fuss over a load of blooming foreigners. Why can't they stay where they belong?
Edward, how could you? I bet if your country was overrun by a brutal invader, you'd be grateful for a few kind words.
It'll all come back on us, you know. All the extra work. If you ask me, the mistress should have consulted us first.
I do wish you were going to be here tomorrow. I only speak schoolroom French.
Won't Uncle Richard be here?
No. He has a meeting at his club.
Well, I'll try and get home early. Anyway, they probably speak perfect English. Now, how does Billy like the Naval Brigade?
He says it's simply splendid. There are so many wonderful people in it. Hawk Asquith, Rupert Brooke and Dennis Brown. Oh, and it's so exciting. Winston Churchill has promised them that if things get really bad in Belgium, he's going to rush them over to hold the line. Of course, it's a great secret.
Well, if it's such a great secret, he shouldn't have told you.
Oh, he knew I wouldn't tell anyone.
You told us.
But that's different.
Well, I know the Naval Brigade is Winston's pet force, but I can't believe that even he would send completely untrained troops into the front line.
Yes, Uncle Richard, he's promised them faithfully. Billy was afraid the war would be over before Christmas, and then he'd never see any fighting. But now he'll be in action before anyone. Isn't it splendid?
Yes, Edward?
The cab's here, sir, for Miss Georgina.
Thank you, Edward. I must rush, or I miss my train. Goodbye, Uncle Richard. And don't work too hard while I'm away.
Send me a postcard and let me know when you'll be back.
I will.
Did you put writing paper in the bedroom, Edward?
Yes, Miss Branson.
And the mistress put flowers in the bedroom and the nursery, too. Cheer him up.
You're quite right, Daisy. After all they've been through, it is our task to make them feel at home.
Well, there's not much pointing us all being here, is there, Mr. Hudson? I mean, I shouldn't think there'd be much luggage.
Maybe not, Edward. But even if they arrive at our door destitute, they are our guests. And we shall behave towards them as we do to all guests in this house.
Yes, Mr. Hudson.
Mr. Bellamy.
This is Mr. Bellamy's house.
Oh, good. Your refugees, Chargon. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Good evening.
The Belgium visitors, madam.
Yes. Vous êtes bienvenu. Entrez, madame. S'il vous plaît. Et madame. Allez. Entrez, monsieur.
Strutson.
going to put on?
I don't know, Rose. We'd better serve tea, then ask the mistress for orders as to sleeping accommodation. Edward?
Tracy, go and put them toys away. And lock the toy cupboard.
Yeah. Would you like to put that on the floor? Here! I wasn't going to steal it, you know.
Rose!
Sorry, Miss Trance.
Rose, I expect it's all she has in the world. She just wants to hold on to it.
Yes, madam. I'll get another cup.
Shall I take her? A moi. Ah, so. There. Manger?
Oh, Manger. Madam, wouldn't put the little girl on your lap if I was you.
Oh, why not, Rose? Oh, I see.
Why not put it on the floor?
Ici. There. Perhaps when she's had something to eat and a glass of milk. Daisy, you could run her a bath with some carbolic in it.
Yes, madam, I think she'd better.
I should put the milk and sugar in, Rose. The Belgian lady Roger doesn't seem to understand.
Oh. Don't scratch. Manger. Oui, madame. Et bon. Oui.
Qu'est-ce que c'est?
Je sais pas.
What on earth is going on?
Oh, sir,
Hudson?
The Belgian visitors, sir, they're not quite what we expected.
Madame,
put him down. Attendez ici. Hazel.
Richard. The children are crawling with lice. And the others too, for all I know. Now, their rooms are ready for them upstairs, but I wanted them to have baths first, so they'd all be
upstairs,
lovely.
Upstairs? That's out of the question. They're Belgian peasants. I can't imagine who put them into the morning room in the first place.
Well, what are we to do with them?
Well, obviously, they must go down to the kitchen and be looked after there. Now, you'll see to it, Hudson.
Very good, sir.
This place is like a bear garden. More than 30 years.
Ruby, get that carbolic bottle off my plate. Oh.
Here, Ruby.
Edward.
Ruby, come and help me with these mashed potatoes.
Come in, Mrs. Bridges.
Right, there we are. Oh. Right. Now, you, bath. Come on.
Let me.
Here. Come here.
Stop it.
You?
No, stop
it.
Stop. Edward, here, you take it.
Oh, not to take your boots off. I'm black and blue.
Edward!
Oh.
Mr. Hudson!
Edward!
Come on, take your boots.
Get in there. Oh, what about him? He's filthy.
Another one?
No. Do you think there will be an invasion?
Well, I don't know. There's a cabinet meeting tonight. We shall know more about it tomorrow.
I wonder how they're getting on downstairs.
Oh, I expect they're managing all right. Hudson, are we getting any dinner?
Yes, sir. I think Mrs. Bridges is very nearly ready.
Hudson, is everything all right?
I expect things will settle down shortly, madam.
But what happens if I want to change my shirt?
Oh, too late to worry about that now.
Now, come on.
Get this bark out of my way. I want to dish up the dinner.
Now then, after dinner, you bath. You bath after dinner.
My bang it, devil is all.
And you. And you.
No, but we still have to live with them.
Mr. Hudson, we haven't had our pudding yet.
No, 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 no smoking. Defense de fumée.
Well!
Les enfants ont mangé quelque chose, hein?
Oh, ben, moi, j'ai pas pu. Bon, je suppose qu'ils ont de bonnes intentions, mais oh, la cuisine anglaise, hein?
Eh ben, moi, je déteste leur pain, pas le café.
Oh, moi aussi.
Excellent.
Ah ben, ils font de leur mieux.
Le mieux?
Ben, moi, je ne comprends pas ces gens, moi. Là, le jeune, là, pourquoi est-ce qu'il n'est pas à l'armée?
Oui, c'est vrai.
Ah. Et puis, tous ces domestiques pour deux personnes. Et tant de chance.
Ah, oui, alors. Je ne sais pas ce que c'est rare.
Ah, non, alors.
Tu crois que les deux en haut sont mariés?
Et beaucoup plus humble, oui.
Oh, ça doit être sa fille.
Oui, mais elle a l'air gentille quand même.
Enfin, moi, je trouve que c'est quand même ridicule qu'on nous met avec des gens qui ne parlent pas le français.
Ouais. Imbécile. Ouais. Ces anglais, ouais. Ouais. Ah,
one in your shut up!
Qu'est-ce que tu dis? Mais... Et toi là-bas, pourquoi tu n'es pas soldat? Boum, boum.
T'as peur?
Ah, non, non.
Mathilde, ton père jamais, c'est lui! J'en ai assez de cette maison.
Ah, oui, je suis jeune.
Comme ça, pas, je ne pas quand même.
What was all that about?
Daisy. She thinks she's caught lice from the Belgians.
Lice? Very unpleasant for her. Presumably they know how to deal with it.
Yes. But if you'd come from a slum and thought you'd left all that behind you, you...
Yes. Yes, I see.
It's not right, Miss Trudson. The mistress should have consulted us before sending them down here.
Well, I say charity begins at home.
So do I. We never get any time to ourselves anymore, clearing up after them. We don't even get our meals in peace.
I wouldn't mind if they was grateful, but they're not.
Oh, I don't even know what the word is. It's a very trying situation, certainly, but I don't quite see what we can do about
it. We could all walk out.
Daisy.
We could all give notice in together.
No, wait a minute, Daisy. Don't be too hasty.
Well, Mr. Hudson, I think the mistress should be told it's them or us.
Yes.
I cannot think how it happened. Dolly Playfair had the most charming couple in her house. Cousins of King Albert and two delightful little girls.
Well, we did not have delightful girls, Prudence, or cousins of King Albert's. We are housing a family of surly, ungrateful Belgian peasants who, incidentally, were infested with lice.
Oh, dear, I am most dreadfully sorry. I'll see what I can do. Oh, by the way, have you seen this leaflet?
Gracious me, whatever next?
What is it?
Have you an able-bodied man serving you who at this moment should be serving your king and country? Have you a man serving at your table who should be serving a gun?
Where on earth do we get this?
They're being distributed by volunteers to all the better houses in London. Violet Berkhamsted's behind it.
Very unpleasant and quite absurd.
Have you thought of sending Edward?
No, certainly not.
Well, don't you think you should? You know, you cannot be too careful in your position.
In my position?
As a member of Parliament.
I hardly think that a mob of enthusiastic but totally untrained recruits is going to halt the advance of a highly mechanized German army.
I'm not saying you'd be any use, Richard. I'm merely saying you should send him. Goodbye, Hazel, my dear. And about those Belgians of yours, I really will see what I can do.
Goodbye, Prudence.
Goodbye, Richard. Ah. Thank you, Edward.
Why can't they use the air?
I did try to tell them about the institution, but they didn't seem to understand.
I don't understand anything. If you ask me, they're half-witted. Oh, no, not again. No fuma in my kitchen, no.
Pardon, madame.
Oh, I just as well talk to a brick wall. Ruby? Fetch me the jam.
It's on the table, Mrs. Bridges.
Ruby! I said fetch me the jam.
It's on the table. Oh, Mrs. Bridges, look!
Oh! You witty boy, come out in there. Come out. Come out, I'll say. Oh, I'll give you such a hiding. Come. Oh! Oh! Oh, that's done it.
Where are you off to, Mrs. Bridges?
I'm going upstairs to see the mistress.
I'll go and get your apron.
I shan't need a clean apron. They're dirty. They're rude. And it's more than flesh and blood concerned.
Mrs. Bridges, Miss Georgina comes back this evening. She went to school in Switzerland. She'll be able to talk to them and make them understand they must behave themselves.
It's not a matter of understanding, madam. It's my kitchen. And either they go or I do.
Happened when we were waiting for the train. Tommy saw one of the grooms and said, "Hello, Parsons, what are you doing here?" And the man said, "I've joined up, sir. I'm going off to fight the Belgians." He'd got it wrong, you see.
Oh, but that's terrible.
Terrible?
Well, to go off to fight and maybe be killed and not know why.
Well, I expect he'd find out later. I shan't know what to say to them.
Oh, do your best.
It's awful, isn't it?
Good evening. I came to see. Good evening, Mrs. Bridges.
Good evening, Miss Georgina.
Bonsoir.
Bonsoir.
Moi, je suis Mademoiselle Worsley, la nièce de Madame Bellamy. Madame.
Oh, Madame Chargon, c'est moi.
Madame Chargon.
Ça, c'est ma belle-sœur, Madame Hugo.
Madame Hugo.
Et ça, c'est mon père, Monsieur Chargon.
Monsieur Chargon.
Et ce sont mes petits-enfants, Jean-Paul. Viens ici, viens. Dis bonsoir à mademoiselle.
Bonsoir.
Célestine.
Voilà, viens.
Dis bonsoir
Célestine.
À mademoiselle.
Voilà. Assieds-toi. Sois sage. Voici Madame Bridges.
Pleased to meet you.
Monsieur Edward. Monsieur Hudson. Monsieur. Mademoiselle Daisy, Mademoiselle Rose, and Mademoiselle Ruby.
Bonsoir.
Bonsoir.
Asseyez-vous. Oh,
merci, merci.
Merci.
Miss Georgina, would you please ask why, when we give them a nice cup of tea,
They spit it out on the ground.
Oh, I think I know that, Mrs. Bridges.
You do?
Well, you see, Belgian people consider tea to be a sort of drug. They would think you were trying to poison them.
Poison? What do they like to drink, then?
Coffee. Vous aimez le café?
Oh,
oui, c'est bon pour la santé, oui.
Suppose we could give them coffee, but don't usually serve it downstairs.
Perhaps you could order a bottle of camp coffee, Mrs. Bridges. That's not too dear.
I suppose they don't like cocoa.
Aimez-vous le chocolat?
Le chocolat,
oui, oui, mais seulement aussi. Ça coûte cher.
They say they love cocoa, and the children do too. They're afraid it's rather expensive.
Well, I expect we could run to that if it's what they really like.
Miss Georgina,
ask them why they never take a bath.
Yeah, ask them that. Oh, I couldn't possibly.
Qu'est-ce que c'est, mademoiselle?
We bathed the children and we told the others they could have a bath after dinner, but they wouldn't.
No, and look at them. They're filthy.
Yes, all they do is have a lick and a promise in my scullery.
Well, perhaps that's all that they could
do. Je comprends pas, moi, qu'est-ce que c'est?
Qu'est-ce qu'il y a?
On parle au sujet du bain.
Oh, mais vous nous aviez dû prendre le bain, là, devant Monsieur Hudson et devant Monsieur Edouard. On ne veut pas se baigner devant les autres pour qu'ils nous comprennent.
Mais vous ne comprenez pas ça?
Ah non, possible.
They said you wanted them to take a bath in front of everyone.
Not in front of everybody.
Well, they said you put the bath out and told them to get into it.
But no, not in front of everybody. I said after dinner. After dinner, you get in the bath. We go and a screen would be put around and when... Not in front of everybody.
I should think not, indeed. I was in the middle of dishing up the dinner.
Mesdames et messieurs, pardonnez-moi, c'était une erreur. Monsieur Hudson et Monsieur Edward seraient partis après le repas pendant votre bain.
Oh, oh c'est ça,
c'est autre chose.
Alors, pardon,
mais non, ça va bien.
Ça va. Well, then ask why they all laughed when the little boy spilt the jam.
Shh, be quiet, Ruby.
No, Mrs. Bridges. Let Ruby ask what she wants to. Sit down, Mrs. Bridges. Easy. Bonsoir.
Bonsoir, madame.
Go on, Ruby.
Well, the little boy stole a pot of jam, Miss Georgina, and dropped it on the floor. And they all laughed.
Pourquoi avez-vous ri quand le petit garçon laissait tomber le pot de confiture?
Oh, excusez-nous, mademoiselle, mais... C'est la première fois qu'on l'a vu redevenir espiègle depuis la mort de son papa. Fusillé.
Fusillé?
Fusillé par les Boches et devant lui.
They say they were glad because it was the first time they'd seen Jean-Paul get into mischief since he saw his father shot.
Shot? Ben, les Allemands, ils ont rassemblé tous les hommes du village et puis ils les ont mis contre un mur et les ont tous fusillés.
Pourquoi?
Ben, parce qu'ils étaient contre eux, mais pour les punir. Ben, regardez le mari, Madame Chargon, là. Il était boiteux, ben, ils l'ont bien tué aussi.
The Germans took all the able-bodied men in the village, stood them against a wall and shot them as a punishment for resisting the German advance. Madame Chargon's husband was lame, but they still shot him. Votre mari?
Il est mort au mois d'août. Et mon fils aussi. Il était soldat comme son papa. Il avait juste 16 ans.
She says her husband was killed in the fighting in August. And her son too. He was in the army, although he was only 16.
Only 16?
Tout le monde savait bien que les Allemands, ils incendiaient les villages et ils violaient les femmes.
They knew the Germans were burning the villages and violaient.
Ouais, violenter, vous comprenez.
Oui, oui. Raping the women. Et alors?
Oh, bah alors on s'est enfui, hein. Madame Chargon avec ses enfants, et monsieur avec sa femme, là, et moi avec ma petite fille.
So they ran away, Madame Chargon, the children, Madame Hugo and her daughter, the old man and his wife.
Malheureusement, un régiment de cavalerie des Uhlans sont arrivés en galopant sur la route et on a été éparpillés.
Pardon?
Éparpillés. De tous les côtés. Ah, oui. Alors on n'a pas retrouvé Madame Chargon. Elle était perdue.
Some German cavalry rode through them. And they all ran away. Afterwards, they couldn't find Monsieur Chargon's wife. She was lost.
Lost?
On a cherché longtemps, mais comme la rue était bombardée, on a dû continuer à cause des enfants.
They searched everywhere, but they couldn't find her. The road was being bombarded, so they had to go on without her for the sake of the children.
That would be the old gentleman's wife, Miss Georgina.
And didn't they ever find her?
Ben alors après, il y a encore eu des bombes et encore des avions.
The aeroplanes came again and dropped more bombs.
J'étais dans un fossé au bord de la route.
Pardon, fossé?
Dans un fossé, au bord de la route.
Madame Hugo was lying in a ditch by the side of the road.
Ben, je tenais ma petite fille. Puis une bombe est arrivée. Je me suis évanouie, sans doute. Quand je suis revenue à moi, j'avais roulé 10 mètres. Et ma petite fille.
With her little girl in her arms. And a bomb fell near and she was knocked out. When she came to, her little girl.
Il restait rien, hein? Ça a dû être la bombe, sans doute, n'est-ce pas? Parce que restait rien. Rien que ça. Ça. Que j'ai gardé avec moi. C'est tout ce qui restait, ma petite fille, là.
There was nothing left of her except...
Oh. I can hardly bear to think of it.
I don't want to think of it. What good does it do? I must change.
You're going out?
Tommy Fox Breeden wanted me to have dinner with him and then see him off at the station. Might as well. It might be rather a lark.
Ah, Madame Yugi, you got the ladle.
Oui.
Good. Put it on the table.
Sur la table, bon.
Yes. And put the condiments and that's me done, Monsieur.
Monsieur, please.
Merci, Monsieur. Ruby, do you remember what I told you?
Oh, yes, Mr.
Ah, excellent.
Still hot. Nice beef stew. And Madame Chargon has made the dumplings.
Ah.
I don't know what they'd be like. They don't make them the same way as what we do.
I'm sure they'll taste excellent. Très bon. Oh. Pan Francaise.
Pan Belge.
Pan Belge. I inquired from Miss Georgina and discovered that in France and Belgium, in farming circles, it is the privilege of the head of the household to cut the bread for the family.
Oh!
Where's Edward? Oh, he ought to be here. He hasn't finished in the dining room yet.
Well, but where is he?
Monsieur Edouard, il est sorti à une heure.
Ah oui, il est sorti.
Oui, sorti. Gonout. Gonout.
Ah, gone out.
Oh, gone out.
Oh,
Edward, wherever have you been?
Edward?
I've been to join up, Mr. Hudson.
Oh, could you, without telling me first?
What if I'd have told you first? You'd try to stop me.
Yes, I would. And so would Mr. Hudson and the master if they'd known.
But I don't belong to them, Daisy. I don't belong to anyone, not even you. Well, you wouldn't think much of me if I did.
Mm. You'd better come and sit down and have your dinner, Edward.
Well, you see, Mr. Hudson, well, everyone kept saying what I ought to do. I mean, well, you and the master and Daisy here saying I shouldn't join up. And, well, there was Lady Berkhamsted and Lady Prudence and that bit of paper said I should.
And Lord Kitchener.
Well, see, I never did think much of the war. I mean, To me, it was just a lot of foreigners bashing each other, but... Well, when I heard about what they were doing over in Belgium, I mean... But you can't let people do things like that and get away with it. Oh, I'm sorry, Mr. Hudson, but I know you've taught me everything I know, but... Well, this time I had to do what I thought was right.
That's what it means, Edward.
Mr. Hudson?
That's what belonging to yourself means. Doing what you think is right.
Oh, yes, Mr. Hudson.
What regiment did you join, my boy?
Oh, the Middlesex, Mr. Hudson. Same as my brother.
We have only just heard the news of the fall of Antwerp. I expect you know more about the war than we do. Men have been simply splendid. I believe we were one of the few brigades who retreated from Mons with all our equipment. Since then, we've seen quite a lot of action. I expect you can guess where we are. There's a salient in the German line of advance, a sort of bulge, a place called Ypres. I heard the lifeguards had been thrown in as a... well, to hold it. We're getting quite expert at digging trenches. The weather's awful. Rain and mud everywhere. I hope we don't get bogged down here for the winter. Please give my love to Hazel and ask her to send me out some flea powder and some warm socks. Best love, James.
I hear you've enlisted, Edward.
Yes, my lady.
When do you have to go?
Oh, they're going to let me know, my lady.
Well done. We must all do what we can.
Lady Prudence, madam.
Hello, Prudence.
Good morning, Richard.
Would you like some coffee, Prudence?
No, thank you, my dear. I can't stop for more than a second. I'm on my way to see Connie Hardcastle. I really just came round to bring you some good news. I've managed to get rid of your Belgians for you.
Oh,
we're sending them off today to a potato farm in Cambridgeshire. They'll be able to make themselves useful there, and they'll feel quite at home.
You know, I'm really going to miss them.
They'll be much better in the country. Come along now, the cab's waiting. Say goodbye.
Au revoir. Au revoir.
Goodbye. Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Goodbye, monsieur.
Goodbye. Good luck.
Au revoir.
Goodbye. Goodbye. Have a good journey.
Bye.
Bye.